So in the previous class, so far we discussed matrix definition, order of the matrix, and corresponding to that some examples related to one mark questions. Now today we will continue the part that is the types of matrices. So there is a possibility of one definition for one mark question if they didn't ask what we discussed in the previous class. That means one mark question possibility is there in types of matrices. Otherwise, the previous class what we discussed so far, that is a construction of a matrix or order of a matrix related question, there will be possibility, or else there might be a chance of related to types of matrices. Here we will discuss one by one types of matrices. In that first one, there is a definition they will ask probably. So in that first one is one column matrix. As a name itself states that, itself indicates that column means what? It has a matrix having only one column, any number of rows. Say what you can redefine it is a matrix having only one column or one column and any number of rows is called a column matrix. What it means, say for example, if you come to, if I consider some examples, you will get the idea, clear idea regarding column matrix definition. What it says, only one column, say for example, A matrix, just look at this, 2, 3, 4. Observe here, you have to identify what is the order of the matrix A. How many rows are there, how many columns are there? 1, 2, 3. As last class we discussed this main one. 1, 2, 3. 3 rows, 1 column. So the order of this matrix is 3 cross 1. And you can observe that only one column, that's why it looks like a column. That's why it is called column matrix. Say for example, one more we will take B matrix. Just observe minus 3, 6. This is an order having what? 2 rows, 1 column. 2 rows, 1 column. Or you can take C matrix. 2, 3, 6, 1. What happened here? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 rows, 1 column. 1 column. That's why it is called column matrix. Next, we will move for second definition. Row matrix. As a similar way, we can define row matrix as well as we discussed the column matrix. The same manner we can define row matrix. We can predict the definition also by having same condition. A matrix having only one row and any number of columns is called row matrix. For example, again we can consider some example, you can very clear idea regarding the definition. Only one row, column, anything, just after 2, 4, 9. What is the order of the matrix? One row, 3 columns, 1 cross 3. If I take a second example, B matrix, can observe 1, 6. What is happening here? One row, 2 columns, 1 cross 2. If I take C matrix, what happened? 0, 6, 1, 3. What happened? One row, four columns, one cross four. These are the examples of row matrices. These are the examples of column matrices. So what happened? Column matrix, as the name itself indicates, only one column. Row matrix only one. We can define very simple way by looking at the statement or by looking at the definition. We can give many more examples regarding that. Now we will look for a third definition, square matrix. We will look up for next definition, square matrix. Here also we can find it very easily. Square, a matrix looks like a square matrix. Say for example, just we can identify here a matrix is said to be square matrix, is said to be square matrix if it has same number of rows and columns, same number of rows and columns, same number of rows and columns. That means a matrix which have equal number of rows and columns. How many rows are there? That much number of columns must be there. For example, if I take example A matrix 2, 4, 6, 8. Look at this. How many elements are there? 4 elements. And how many rows are there? 2 rows. How many columns are there? 2 columns. 2 cross 2 ordered matrix it is. That means what? It looks like a square. That's why it is a square matrix. And we can observe same number of rows, same number of columns. You can take one more example, B matrix as sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, minus sin theta, minus cos theta, tan theta, minus tan theta, cot theta. Observe, how many rows are there here? Three rows, three columns. One of the main thing here, we have to define some point here. Equal number of rows and equal number of columns means compulsory it is a square matrix. It has some particular special ideas, special features in this chapter and next chapter also. A square matrix having a major rule here. Generally ordered 3 cross 3 matrix will be 3 cross 3 ordered matrix will be of generally it is in the form A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. I said in the previous class, generally in ordered 3 cross 3 matrix will be take this form. I said this indicate what? Second row first column indicate, second row second column. It is a position, it is indicating a position. Now what we have to do? We have to concentrate. Just look at this. It is called diagonal. The elements like A11, A1, A22, A33, A44, not it is there, and so on. AMM. Here, this constitute a diagonal. These are called what? Diagonal elements. Diagonal elements, look at this example 2, 8. These are the diagonal elements of the matrix A, and these are the elements of the diagonal elements of the matrix B. Usually, generally the diagonal elements indicating this form A11, A22, A33, A44. If I said here, if A is a matrix, if A is a matrix of order, if A is a, if A is a square matrix, if A is a square matrix of order 2, if I said, I didn't mention 2 cross 2, 2 cross 3 like that. If I said A is a square matrix of order 2, square matrix means equal number of rows and equal number of columns. square matrix of order 2 in the sense it takes a general format A11, A12, A21, A22. It is a matrix of order 2. Square matrix of order 2 means 2 number of rows, 2 number of columns. A square matrix of order 3 means, square matrix of order 3 means 3 cross 3, 3 number of rows and 3 number of columns. If I said a matrix of order 3, it doesn't mean it. A matrix of order 3 means it not okay. Now I said a square matrix of order 3 means this will come. Here square matrix of order 2 means this will come. Generally a square matrix of order m means what? A square matrix of order m means what? M number of rows, m number of columns. What is the speciality in a square matrix? The diagonal elements you have to observe in having i equal to j. Okay? I equal to j. Where in I equal to j, those elements are called diagonal elements, especially in a square matrix. Especially in a square matrix. Look at this definition. You got the point, I think. A square matrix is a very simple definition. What happened? Square matrix means what? A matrix having same number of rows and columns. If a matrix having number of rows and number of columns are same, then it is called a square matrix. And especially one thing I forgot to say, that if I say A is equal to 2, if it is like this, what is the order of this matrix? What is the order of this matrix? One row, one column. One row, one column means it is a square matrix. Number of rows, number of columns same. And it is column matrix as well. Column matrix why? Because one column. It is as well as a row matrix. Why? Because it is only one row. But it is, we will consider usually it is a square matrix. What is the nature of, what is the definition of square matrix? A matrix which having same number of rows and columns is called square matrix. Now we will define a very important definition. I think fourth one, diagonal matrix. Very important definition. There ask this question frequently. Diagonal matrix. We will rewrite it now. A square matrix. I am repeating, A square matrix A is said to be, just look at A square matrix, it should be a square matrix, is said to be diagonal matrix if all its non-diagonal elements, just look at this. Non-diagonal elements are zeros. Zeros means all remaining. Other than non-diagonal elements, all must be zero. I didn't mention about diagonal elements. Just observe. Say for example, A matrix is a square matrix. It should be a square matrix, compulsory. You have to observe, it should be a square matrix. It means it is a m number of rows, m number of columns only. So now, diagonal means whatever, if I take a 3 cross 3 matrix, 3, 0, 0, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 6. Look at this. What happened? Non-diagonal elements. These are non-diagonal elements. These are diagonal elements. Diagonal means whatever they are, remaining elements must be zero. That is called a diagonal matrix. Say for example, one more example I will take. Matrix B. 2, 0, 0, 3. Observe, these are not diagonal elements, these are diagonal elements. Those are not zero. I didn't mention that. Not whatever it may be, but these must be zeros. This is called a diagonal matrix. A diagonal matrix in the sense what? A square matrix in which all non-diagonal elements are zeros. Non-diagonal elements. Whatever the diagonal elements may be. Now come to the point. Next definition. Fifth one. Got the idea? This is asked frequently. And one more thing. This is very important also.
Now we will discuss next definition, scalar matrix. Most of the time they ask this one, and this makes a very important rule also, some concept. Scalar matrix. Scalar matrix in the sense, it is also a diagonal matrix. I said, what is a diagonal matrix? Just now I defined. A diagonal matrix in which all diagonal elements are same or equal or same, or you can observe it is a square matrix, diagonal matrix in a sense it looks like this. And what happened, one more thing, all diagonal elements are same, it means what? Diagonal elements, what I written here, 3, 4, 6. It is not a scalar matrix. Here, those are different. This is not a scalar matrix. If I take one more example, just observe, A matrix, if I take 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0. Observe, is it a diagonal matrix? I am observing, I am repeating my question. Is it a diagonal matrix? Yes, it is a diagonal matrix. And what is the definition? Square matrix or non-diagonal. And after that, now we are discussing scalar matrix. What is a scalar matrix? It is a diagonal matrix in which diagonal elements are equal. Yes, it is a diagonal elements, diagonal matrix as well. Even though it is a special case and it is a diagonal elements are same. That's why this is called scalar matrix. Scalar matrix in the sense, diagonal elements are same. Here, it is satisfying all non-diagonal elements 0. We can predict, we can say that a general, one more example I will say, B matrix, just observe, 5, 0, 0, 5. It is order 2 cross 2 matrix, it is order 3 cross 3 matrix, 0, 0, non-diagonal element 0, diagonal elements same. And observe, generally, if I say a matrix A is a square matrix, AIJ of order M, M cross M means M number of rows, M number of columns. It is a square matrix in which equal number of rows and equal number of columns means square matrix. Square matrix in that diagonal matrix, scalar matrix. Here I am defining scalar matrix in another way. If just look at this, AIJ is equal to 0 if I is not equal to J. A I Z equal to K. If I equal to J. A I Z. If A I Z equal to K. K means it is 3, maybe 5, whatever. A I Z equal to 0 means what? A I Z equal to 0 means where I is not equal to J. This is the position of what? First row, second column, first row, third column, first row. Sorry, second row, third column. This is the second row. First column, these are the positions where I am not equal to J. These are the position where I equal to J. Just now I just discussed it. Diagonal, square matrix, diagonal matrix. Square matrix and I said, these I equal to J. Where I equal to J, it is a same number. Where I am not equal to J, all elements are 0. Here we can redefine diagonal matrix as a AIJ of order M, where if what? A I Z equal to 0 if I is not equal to J. This is only one condition here. Whatever the diagonal elements, that is called diagonal matrix, non-diagonal elements 0, compulsory. Here what happened? Diagonal elements 0, non-diagonal elements same. Sorry, non-diagonal elements 0, diagonal elements same. That is why this makes also important rule in solving some problems. This is another definition of a diagonal matrix. This is another definition of a scalar matrix. Now we will discuss next point, point number 6. Okay, next one we will discuss next definition, sixth one, that is identity matrix. So identity matrix. So identity matrix means a matrix, a square matrix, or you can write
a scalar matrix in which all diagonal elements are unity in the sense equal to 1, right? Equal to 1, all diagonal elements are equal to 1. Scalar matrix, just now we discussed scalar matrix in sense non-diagonal elements 0, diagonal elements same. Diagonal elements same and it is equal to 1 means it is called identity matrix. Usually identity matrix of order n is denoted by I, capital I, m means it is order n. I usually write I. I means identity. Say for example, it may be order 2 matrix. Order 3 you can take first one example. Order 3 matrix of identity matrix will be of the form. And observe that it is satisfied all the conditions of a scalar matrix. Is it a scalar matrix? Yes, of course it is. It is a square matrix? Yes, it is of course a square matrix. Is it a diagonal matrix? Yes, it is a diagonal matrix. Non-diagonal elements are zeros, diagonal elements are 1. We can redefine the identity matrix as well. It is order 3. Redefine one more type, definition is what? A square matrix in which non-diagonal elements are zeros, diagonal elements equal to 1. You can rewrite this also. Or if you can write this, if A equal to Aij, m cross n, order m cross n means square matrix, is said to be identity matrix. If Aij equal to 0, if i is not equal to j, Aij equal to 1, if I equal to j, where I is equal to j, 1, I is not equal to j, 0. One more example if I take, order 2 identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1, diagonal elements equal to 1, non-diagonal elements 0. You can redefine one more time like this also. A equal to A, I, J, M cross M, M number of rows, M number of columns. Generally, is said to be identity matrix if A, I, J equal to 0. Where I is not equal to J. I is not equal to J means non-diagonal elements. I equal to J means diagonal elements. That's why we can rewrite like this also. Or you can use this one. Or you can modify a square matrix in which non-diagonal elements 0, diagonal elements equal to 1. That is called identity matrix. It is denoted by I. This you can denote I3, this I can denote I2, I4, IN, generally identity matrix of order n. Yeah. And usually we will use this notation most of the time in this particular chapter and in the next relevant chapter also. There might be a definition logical in this case also. Next, we will continue next definition, 7th one we will discuss now. 7th one is zero matrix or null matrix. Zero matrix or null matrix, as the name itself indicate, what null matrix is one. You can observe zero matrix. A matrix is said to be zero matrix if all its elements are zero. A matrix is said to be zero matrix or null matrix if all its elements are zeros. All its elements are
0 irrespective of their order and whatever. Square matrix order is important, diagonal matrix order is important, scalar matrix order is important, because order makes a definition. Now zero matrix, no, whatever it is, and it is denoted by O usually, and it is denoted by capital O. Okay, O matrix. You can write some examples. 0, 0, 0, 0. It is order 2 cross 2 null matrix. You can write 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. How many rows? 3 rows, 2 columns. 3 cross 2 order matrix. 2 cross 2 order. These are null matrix. Whatever. This is a null matrix. Null matrix in the sense? All elements are 0. A matrix having all elements are 0. This is last type of a definition of a 0 matrix. What happened here? Diagonal matrix, very important rule, and scalar matrix, very important rule in annual examination. So here, 0 matrix, except row matrix, column matrix, 0 matrix are not much important thing. And very important thing is what? Square matrix, diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, and identity matrix. These are makes very important for annual examination for 1 mark. Now, we will discuss some point here. Actually, it is not there in your syllabus now, but we will define a triangular matrix. We need it. Triangular matrix. Triangular matrix in the sense, a square matrix in which all elements above the diagonal or below the diagonal, are zero. For example, square matrix. It should be a square matrix. 1, 0, 0, 3, 4, 0, 1, 6, 7. Observe. This is the diagonal. Above the diagonal, all elements are zeros. Or you can take one more example. 4, 9, 6. 0, 1, 10, 0, 0, 5. Observe. Here all the above diagonal elements are 0, or below the diagonal elements, these are 0s. These are called triangular matrices. Here, this is called a triangular formed in this one. Can observe. This is called lower triangular matrix. Just observe. Above 0s, lower triangular matrix. This is called lower triangular matrix. Below zero, this is called upper triangular matrix. Above zero, lower triangular matrix. Below zero, upper triangular matrix. Just look at this. Below zero, upper triangular. Above zero, lower triangular. You will come to know the next chapter. We will identify and while studying the determinant chapter, we need it. We will discuss it later. Even though they won't ask this question usually, but the most important thing we discussed already till 7. Triangular matrix, in that upper triangle, lower triangle. But we need where we study the determinant chapter, in that we will discuss about those things also. Now come to the point, types of matrices. It's over now. What are the things we discussed? I said, and repeatedly, 1 mark question will be there. Now, we will discuss, next we will continue the part, next concept, equality means two matrices are said to be equal. What are the conditions? So how we will define? Just look at this. If A equal to A I J, one matrix, and one more matrix B equal to, elements are represented by B I J, are two matrices, said to be equal. There are two conditions for this concept, for making the equality of two matrices said to be equal, if first condition, they are of same order. They are of same order. Order of the matrices must be same. Order of the matrices must be same. Second question, each element of matrix A is equal to corresponding element of matrix B. We will discuss it now. What it means, that is A I J equal to B I J for all I J. What it means, A I J equal to B I J. Each element of matrix A is equal to the corresponding element of matrix B. And what main thing is that order must be same. If order is not same, then matrix is not compulsory. This point you have to be very careful. Say for example, A is a matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a matrix of order 2×2. 2, 1, 3, 4. Just observe. 2, 1, 3, 4 or 2, 3, 1. Look at this example. Just order or same, both having the equal order, same order. This condition okay. First condition okay. Second condition is what? Each element of matrix A is equal to the corresponding element. What it means? A I J equal to B I J. I said repeatedly, the positions are very important. What is the position of this element? 1, first row, first column. What is the first row, first column element here? 2. 1 is not equal to 2. Just observe. This position must be same, equality. Here we can conclude A is not equal to B. Why? Because each element is equal to corresponding element. Every element, just look at this. 4 is there, 4, okay, right? But 2 is there, 3 is there. This is not equal matrix. So just say for example, if I say A 3, 6, 4, A is equal to 1, 3, 6, 4. If it is a possible case, this implies compulsory these two matrices are equal. If it is given that order is same, yes, 3 is there, 6 is there, 4 is there, then A must be equal to 1. This is the condition. Or else, you can observe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Matrix is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will take, this is A matrix, this is the B matrix. Just look at this. This is order 3 rows, 2 columns. This is order 3 rows, 2 columns. 3×2, 3×2. 1, 1, 2, 2. Positions are same. Therefore, these are equal matrices. Equality holds in matrices. These two conditions satisfy. What are those conditions? Order must be same. And each element of the matrices are equal to the corresponding element of other matrices, matrix. It makes some important examples regarding this definition. We will solve some examples. After that, we will clear the definition. Equality means elements wherever the positions is very important rule. So you may ask the question, if x, y, z, a, 3, 4 is equal to 1 minus 1 root 3, 6, 3, 4. then find x, y, z, e. Just observe. What is the question? Observe the example. These two matrices are equal. Already given that. What are the? Find the value of x, y, z, and a value. So what happened? Solution we can observe. What happened? Solution is what? X replaced. X is a place name with what? X is equal to 1. Y place is what? Y is equal to minus 1. Z is equal to what? Root 3. A equal to what? 6. 3 equal to 3, 4 equal to yes. It is over. So this is the question they might be. We can discuss about that one. And next we will continue the next part question. If they might the question if matrix is look like this. X plus 3 minus 6 B minus 3 Z plus 4 A minus 1 minus 21 2y minus 7 0 0 is equal to 0 6 0 6 3y minus 2 10y minus 2 minus 6 minus 3 2c plus 2 2c plus 2 0 2b plus 4 2b plus 4 minus 21, 0. Find A, B, C, X, Y, Z. These values we need to find. So, equality holds. He has given already. So, what is the position X plus 3 is equal to what? Position. By using the position, equality of matrices definition. X plus 3 is equal to 0. This implies x is equal to minus 3. X equal to minus 3. Next, second, z plus 4 equal to 6. Z plus 4 equal to 6. Z equal to 6 minus 4, 2. Z equal to 2. Next, third position, 2y minus 7 is equal to 3y minus 2. No drill. Just you can observe. Third, first row, third column. First row, third column. First row, third column. Position is made very important. Send this 2y here, minus 2 here, minus 7 plus 2 is equal to 3y minus 2y. What happened? Minus 7 plus 2 minus 5, y value is minus 5. Next, look at this minus 6 minus 6 over limit. A minus 1 is a minus 1 is equal to a minus 1 replaced it is a position minus 3. A is equal to you send this to right side. What happened? Minus 2. A value is minus 2. Next, 0, here 2c plus 2, so 2c plus 2 must be equal to 0, 2c is equal to minus 2, c is equal to, send this to denominator, minus 2 by 2 minus 1. Next, b minus 3, 2b plus 4, both are equal, b minus 3 is equal to 2b plus 4. What happened? Send this to right side, minus 3 minus 4, 2b minus b. So, minus 7 is equal to b. Next condition. Minus 21, minus 21, 0, 0. Everything over? X, y, x, z, y, a, b, a, c, b. Everything over. What they asked? A, b, c, and then x, y, z. These are the values. We can find by using the definition, we can, using the condition of equality of matrices, we can conclude these questions. Solution A, B, C, X, Y, Z values